Hello everyone and welcome back once again. This is your science teacher here and this time I'm here with the third chapter of grade 6 science NCERT textbook, that is fiber to fabric. Students, as you all know that along with food and shelter, clothing is also a basic need of our lives, and clothes protect us from external factors like heat, cold and rain. And students, we usually wear clothes based on climates, occasions and also according to the present fashion trends. And all these clothes that we wear are basically prepared from the fibers. So students, in this chapter, we will learn and discuss that what is fiber and what are the different sources of fibers. So let's start. Now students, as you can see here the heading, variety in fibers. But students, moving on towards the chapter, it is necessary for all of you to understand some basic terms that will help you to understand this chapter more clearly. The first one is yarn. Student, yarn is a long continuous length of interlocked fibers that are basically suitable for use in the production of textiles, sewing, knitting, weaving, embroidery and rope making. And students, the thread that we basically used is a type of yarn that is basically intended for sewing by hand or machine. The next term is fiber. Students, fibers are thin, long, flexible and hair, or you can say thread-like structures. And students, these fibers are usually obtained from two main sources, that are plant and animals. And students, these fiber twisted together to form yarn, and these yarn when interlocked in different patterns, then they form fabric. Students, now the question is that where do fibers come from? Students, as I said earlier also, that fibers are usually obtained from two main sources, that are plant and animals. And these fibers that we get from plant and animals are called natural fibers, like silk, cotton, jute, etc. Whereas apart from natural fibers, there are synthetic fibers also that are basically synthesized by humans with the help of machines and technologies in the textile industries. And such kind of fibers are called synthetic fibers, like rayon, nylon, polyester, etc. Now students, let's discuss that what are natural and what are artificial or synthetic fibers. Students, natural fibers are those fibers that basically come from plants and animals, and as they are obtained from nature, that's why they are called as natural fibers, like cotton, silk, jute, linen, etc. And students, as you know that we get jute and cotton from plants, and whereas wool is acquired from the fleece of goat or sheep. And in fact, we get wool not only from goat or sheep, we also acquired wool from yak, rabbits and camels. And in the same way, silk fibers can be acquired from cocoon of silkworms. Now synthetic fibers. Students, as I said, synthetic fibers are those kind of fibers that are basically synthesized by humans with the help of machines in the textile industries. And these fibers are also called as man-made fibers, as they are made by men. And their examples are rayon, nylon and polyester. As you can see here also in this figure, these are artificial fibers or man-made fiber. Now, students, let's discuss some plant fibers elaborately. As the first one is cotton. Students, now the question is that where does cotton wool come from? Students, cotton plants are generally grown in that places where usually having a warm climate and black soil. Means the good production of cotton crops needs warm climate and black soil. And in India, the major cotton producing states are Punjab, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Maharashtra, etc. Means these states have a suitable warm climate and black soil for the good overall production of cotton crop. Students, cotton plants bear fruits the size of a lemon, and that is basically called as cotton ball. Means the fruit of the cotton plant is known as cotton ball. And students, that cotton ball bursts open upon when it matures, and the seeds wrapped up in cotton fiber becomes visible, and then this cotton generally picked by hand from these balls. As you can see here, this is the matured cotton balls, and this whitish part overall here is the cotton that is basically picked up by hand. Students, after the picking the cotton from the cotton ball, the next process is ginning. Students, ginning is that process in which basically the cotton seeds are separated from the cotton fibers. And students, traditionally this ginning process used to be done by hand. As you can see here in this figure, this boy separating the cotton seeds from the cotton fibers, and it is one of the traditional method. But nowadays people use double roller cotton ginning machines. As you can see here, this is the double roller cotton ginning machine that are widely used to separate cotton seeds from cotton fibers. Students, the next natural fiber is jute. And students, this jute fiber is basically obtained from the stem of jute plant. As you can see here, this is the jute plant, and jute is obtained from the stem of this plant. And students, unlike cotton, jute is cultivated in rainy season, whereas cotton is cultivated in warm climate. And in India, some of the major jute producing states are Bihar, Assam and West Bengal, as they receive heavy rainfall. So here in these states, the overall production of jute is good. And students, the important point that you must kept in your mind is jute is basically harvested during flowering stage. Means when the plant start bearing flower, means this is the suitable time to harvest the jute plant. Then students, after harvested the jute plants, the stem of these plants are then soaked in water for about 4 to 5 days. Then students, the stems are left over there in water for 4 to 5 days to rot. And then the fibers are picked out by hand after 4 to 5 days. And then from these fibers, yarn is taken out in order to make a thread to produce a fabric. Now students, as you can see here, the heading, spinning cotton yarn. Students, spinning is that process in which the yarn is basically constructed from fibers. And in this, a huge heap of cotton wool are taken out and twisted, and then this twisted fiber together to form a yarn. And students, there are basically two major devices that are used to spin, and that are tuckling and charkha. As you can see here, students, that is the takli, and that one is the charkha. Students, takli basically a traditional device that is used to spin, and it is used to spin by hand. And the next one, charkha, is also a traditional method to spin the yarn, and it is also operated by hand. But students, nowadays spinning of yarn on a bigger scale is usually done using spinning machines in large textile industries. And students, the fabric that usually made after spinning the yarn by traditional method from takli and charkha are known as khadi. Means khadi is the term that is used to denote clothes which were generally made from homespun yarn, means takli and charkha. Now students, in this section we will discuss that how fabric is made from yarn. Now students, here also two major ways by which yarn is converted to fabric, and these two methods are weaving and knitting. Students, weaving is that process in which two sets of yarn simultaneously used to make fabric. And students, this process is basically done by using a loom. As you can see here, this whole machine is known as loom. And in this machine, two sets of yarns interlaces at right angle to each other to form a fabric. Students, the next method to obtain fabric from yarn is knitting. Students, knitting is that process in which a single strand of yarn is generally used to make a piece of fabric, like socks, sweater, mufflers that we basically wear during winter seasons are all made from single strand of yarn. And as you all know that knitting can be done by hand as well as by machines. Now students, let's discuss the history of clothing material. Students, as you all know that in earlier times, when people didn't have access or didn't have any knowledge to process fiber, then they used to wear big leaves and the bark of trees in order to cover themselves. But students, after settlement in agriculture community, these people learn how to weave, and they use grasses and twigs to make mats or baskets, and they also use animal hair or fleece and vines of different plants that they wrap together into stretch out strands, which they were then woven into fabrics. And students, during early time, the abundant growth of cotton is basically around the Ganga Valley, as there are fertile soil and water is available. So the early Indians who readily used to make fabrics for themselves belong to these Ganga Valleys. Now students, as I said in the first slide, that there are different kind of plants from where we get fibers. And as we discussed, two plant fibers also, jute and cotton. And there is another one that is generally used to acquired fiber, and that is flax. Students, during early times, not only the Indian peoples learned to cultivate cotton and flax, in fact the early Egyptian peoples also learned to cultivate both cotton and flax, and they used them to create fabrics. And students, like in India, these peoples belong to the Ganga Valley. In the same way, in Egypt, these people basically belong to the River Nile valleys. Students, but in those days, people were not aware of process of stitching. So they just simply wrap around the fabrics around different part of their bodies. And students, you will amazed to know that even today, we also wear unstitched clothes like saris, dhotis, lungis, or turbans. And students, when science developed, then people learned to stitch the fabrics with the help of the swing needle. And with the discovery of the swing needle, people learned how to stitch fibers to make fabric. Now, students, that's all about your chapter. And with this topic here, your chapter number 3 is completed. So I will be come back soon with another chapter. Till then, stay home, stay safe, stay healthy.